The Vaccinated Because Science shirt is available at the link below. Check them out if you're interested.
Hey y'all, welcome back. I'm Mama Dr. Jones, a board certified OBGYN and mom to four. And today we're going through five myths about your breasts that you probably still believe. If you learned something in this video, please give it a like. If you're new and you'd like to subscribe, we would love to have you. We talk about all things pregnancy, gynecology, breasts, sex ed, all of that. If you don't like impressing your friends with that knowledge, then don't subscribe because I guarantee you'll leave here with things to tell your friends. Let's jump in to the video. Number one, breastfeeding causes breast sag. This has been disproven in the literature, and despite that, I still see medical professionals online and in real life telling patients this. It's absolutely not true. So if that's not true, what actually causes breast sag? Well, the primary factor in breast sag is genetics and gravity. Over time, the Cooper's ligament, which is the suspensory ligament of the breast, just succumbs to gravity and time. It gets a little bit more lax, and this leads to breast sag.
The breast is anchored to the pectoralis major muscle by suspensory ligaments, and in fact, these suspensory ligaments of Cooper become more loose and stretch with increasing age. And this is a significant contributing factor to the breast becoming ptotic or low-hanging.
Other things that contribute are the number of pregnancies someone has. Breastfeeding, not a risk factor. Number of pregnancies is a risk factor. Why? Because hormonal changes cause the breast to increase and decrease in size. So this leads to rapid changes, which alter the skin and alter the muscle and alter the glands, and that can lead to more breast sag. So in that same vein, large amounts of weight gain and weight loss can contribute. And really importantly, a lot of things in your lifestyle can contribute. So smoking, for example, decreases the elastin in your skin and body tissues, and this leads to increased wrinkles on the face, but also more sagging in the breast. So these are all things that can contribute. The primary factors are genetics, gravity, and time, as well as the number of pregnancies, but definitely not whether or not you breastfeed. So if you want to breastfeed, breastfeed away. It's not going to affect how your breasts sag. Number two, all lumps are breast cancer. This is absolutely not true. In fact, in people under the age of 30, a breast lump is far more likely to be something called a fibroadenoma or just general dense breast tissue or fibrocystic breasts. And this is really, really common. Fibroadenomas are super common. They're also common over the age of 30, but at that point we do get slightly more concerned. Although I still want to reiterate that most lumps over the age of 30 still aren't breast cancer. However, all lumps at any age should be checked out. So if you notice a lump while you're doing a breast exam, always, always, always have your doctor or advanced practice provider take a look at it. Number three, my breasts are just right here. That's absolutely not true. Breast tissue extends all the way up into the armpit. So if you're doing a self breast exam, you need to start all the way up in the armpit and go in a circular motion in a way that you can make sure you cover the entirety of the breast. This breast tissue extending up into the armpits is also a reason why sometimes when people are breastfeeding, they will get engorgement all the way up into their armpits. So don't ignore the breast tissue in your armpits either for breast problems that you may be having or for self-exams at home. You also need to just have general awareness of what's normal for your breasts. We call this breast self-awareness, and we encourage you to just look in the mirror every time you're getting in the shower, take note of what your breasts look like and how they're shaped, and if something changes, let your healthcare provider know. This is really, really important because breast cancer doesn't always present as a lump. Sometimes you may have no symptoms, in which case it's really important that you're getting routine mammogram screening over the age of 40. It's a little debatable about exactly when we should start, but also it can sometimes present as just a change in size or an indentation or changes in the skin. So being self-aware of what your breasts look like on a normal day-to-day basis is really important. Number four, sleeping in a bra is good or bad. I hear this myth both ways all the time. So what's the truth? The truth is, it doesn't matter. If you wanna sleep in a bra, you can sleep in a bra. If you don't wanna sleep in a bra, it's totally fine. It's not going to increase breast sag in the future. Whatever is most comfortable for you is totally fine. I do occasionally recommend that someone sleeps in a sports bra or some other type of bra, generally without an underwire because it's more comfortable, if they are having nipple chafing. What happens sometimes is a loose t-shirt while you're sleeping at night can rub across the nipples and cause lots of pain and chafing. And if that's happening, sometimes we can fix that just by sleeping in a sports bra or something that's a little more tight fitting so you don't have that constant friction through the night. Other than that, Whatever's comfortable for you is totally fine. You'll probably want to choose a breathable fabric, something that's comfy, something that doesn't have an underwire, but honestly, there's no good or bad. Whatever works for you. Number five, bras, deodorant, etc. cause breast cancer. This is absolutely not true. A bra with or without an underwire, a bra sleeping in it or not sleeping in it at night, deodorant with or without aluminum, none of these things cause breast cancer. Primarily, breast cancer is either genetic or spontaneous, meaning somebody in your family carries a gene that makes you at an increased risk of breast cancer, or you just spontaneously get breast cancer and we don't exactly know. This is multifactorial. There are genetics, there are things we don't know, and then there are lifestyle things. Living a generally healthy life, exercising, eating right, not smoking, and not drinking too much alcohol are all things that can help decrease your risk of breast cancer in the future. So what did we learn? Breastfeeding does not cause breast sag. All breast lumps are definitely not cancer. Your breast tissue extends all the way up into your armpit. Sleeping in a bra is neither good nor bad. It's all about what's comfortable to you. And breast cancer is not caused by bras or deodorant. If you learned something, leave a like on this video. If you're new here, we would love to have you subscribe. We talk about all things pregnancy, gynecology, breasts, etc. And you can impress your friends with your knowledge. I will link a playlist of other videos that you might enjoy right over here. Be kind to yourself, to each other, to me. In the comments, be kind, and I will see you next Monday.